There's a lot of talk about chai in the news lately, and there's so many iffy recipes out there. Let me show you how I make the classic Indian chai. Now, chai for me is a ritual. It's not just some caffeinated drink I make for myself every morning. That smell of chai actually wakes me up. It's my precious me time. The time I dedicate to the cup of chai, making it, putting my fresh spices, is like the time I give to myself in the day. Because the rest of the day just flies. As a mother in America, as a wife, as an actor, it's pretty much no time. On my set as an actor, I used to have a lot of chai in between my scenes and while waiting for close-ups. Chai in India is like coffee in America. We wake up, we like to smell that fresh cup of chai. And people in America call it chai tea. It's like saying tea tea. Anyway, it's chai. I didn't grow up having a lot of chai, but as I get older and now that I'm in America, it kind of reminds me of my roots. I saw my mom, dad have 4 or 5 cups of chai every day. And even in the middle of the night, they get up and have chai. And I was like, why do they like chai so much? But now I'm hooked. There's so many different kinds of chai available in India. On the streets of Mumbai, you get cutting chai. In North India, you get something called kullad wali chai. Now, kullad is nothing but a small little clay mug. Those clay mugs add flavor to the chai. If someone visits me here and if I offer them a cup of chai, it's my way of saying that I like you. I want to have a conversation with you. So let's talk about what all we need for this chai today. Basic requirements are the tea leaves and ginger. That's the basic. If you have tea leaves and ginger, you're set. I love ginger in my chai. I cannot do without it. There are different kinds of chai and you can add different kinds of spices, masalas to it. And that's what makes it masala chai. You can add cloves, ginger, lemongrass, cardamom, you name it. Lots of options. But I do recommend getting the masala chai from an Indian store, which is black tea, or you can use black tea leaves. Now for lemongrass, I actually use this dehydrated lemongrass and not fresh lemongrass because it's very hard to come by in my area. But this actually smells the same, tastes the same, and gives it the same flavor. Now let's get to that cup of chai. I've taken like 1.5 cup of water because some of it evaporates while you're boiling it. And then I peel the ginger and I'm going to grate it. Alright, make sure you get all that fresh, yummy ginger in the tea. It's great for your throat as well every morning. Just amazing. Alright, I'm going to turn this on. And then I feel like doing some cloves this morning. So I'm taking just 2, throwing it in there. I love lemongrass. The smell of lemongrass in the morning, yummy. And I'm gonna do 1 stick of cinnamon today. I'm gonna break it up because that's when all the flavors just release in the water. Now, for chai, the tea I use is this. It's just black tea, all right? I'm gonna give 3 teaspoons of this. I'm just making 1 cup of chai for myself. And there's a little extra usually, so you can always have some more. Now I'm gonna let this boil nicely until it's this lovely amber color. I'll show you how that looks. Just starting to boil. You see how the color of the water is changing? You gotta let it boil for a few minutes. At least, I would say 8 to 10 minutes on a medium. This off. Take a strainer. See this gorgeous amber color? So you can boil it for a long time. I like to boil it for a long time. But if you don't want it too strong, boil it a little lesser. Then I take 2% milk, but you can use anything. Almond milk, soy milk, hemp milk, whatever you like, right? I'm using 2%. Some people like skim. So I'm just going to use a little drop. Now this again is up to you, how strong you want to make it. I'm going to add some sugar. I'm going to stir it good. I'm always spilling, so clumsy. So that is my perfect cup of chai. I can smell the lemongrass, I can smell the cinnamon.